His name's Musa, right? His nickname's Moose. So, like, social media and stuff, whenever he goes off like he did today, I want y'all tweeting out the Moose is loose. All right? You got a pet moose and everything. Little stuffed animal. That's what we say. So you guys need to be saying that, too. We need to get, like, all of Ohio State saying that. All right, you guys can go.
Well, with that in mind, they cut it to two there late, and you guys answered like a 13-0 run. And I feel like watching this team the last couple of years, you guys might not have answered in that way before. Why were you guys able to answer the bell tonight, and what does that maybe say about what this team has internally?
Yeah, well, I mean, you learn from your mistakes, right? I mean, over the past couple of years, we very well have lost that game. But, you know, with coaches just saying, you know, this is exactly what we want in the huddle. You know, there's always going to be times of adversity, especially with a brand new team and a brand new staff like we have. And it's up to us to lock down and go through that adversity. It's going to get worse the rest of the year. We got a lot more tough competition coming through that we got with games coming up, especially in the PK80 next week. And it was just a small little test for us, and we passed it.
When you talk about adversity, not just on the court, but when Caleb doesn't play, and obviously that's going to put a little bit more on your shoulders, how did that impact you tonight?
Well, my teammates helped me out a lot, and Caleb actually helped out a lot, too. I mean, even though he was out of the game, he was the loudest one on the bench, him and Joey. That's something that we got to be able to continue to do. You know, it's next man up. If guys can't play, they got to be able to fulfill their role of being loud on the bench, and Caleb did a great job with that today.
Musa, what was a greater moment for you, getting your first start or being the Twitter model for the new jerseys you guys are going to wear next week?
That might be a tough one. I don't know. The Instagram picture was pretty cool, but definitely the start, because I've been working real hard in practice, and I'm just happy that Coach Holtman blessed me with the opportunity to play and start the game, you know, and I just played as hard as I could.
When did you find out you were starting, and then like, did you approach it any differently once you didn't know you were going to start?
I didn't find out till kind of like shoot around before one of the assistant coaches told me, like, you might be starting, and then probably at like 5, one of the coaches was like, yeah, you definitely started. And so I didn't want to try to think about it too much, you know, just warm up like I used to and just get going.
You had, I know you had obviously had a scoring going in the first half and then you didn't score for a while, but you had two swats at the rim on some of those oops they were trying that really seemed to ignite you guys defensively. I guess what I'm asking is, the importance of when you're not scoring, finding ways to impact the game in other ways. You seem to do that tonight, and is that something you think you can bring for this team moving forward?
Yeah, that's exactly what I'm going to do. That's going to be my MO. You know, I'm not out here to get 30 a night, and I mean, that'd be great if that happened, but I'm just out there to play defense and just bring the energy for the team.
You just mentioned energy, and that's what I was going to ask. What does it take to do something like that, to bring that energy? What kind of mentality do you have if you're not, you know, necessarily scoring or getting statistics again?
It's just play every single possession one by one. And once you do that, you push yourself to your limit every possession, and then good things happen after a while.
And Micah, you're a guy who brought a lot of energy last year. What do you see in him in that respect, I guess?
It makes my job easier. I mean, and it's not only Moose. Like I said, Caleb was bringing energy from the bench today. Cam was. Joey always is. You know, our bench did a great job bringing energy today. And then the crowd did a good job, too. There's a couple times I had to kind of get them going a little bit. But the crowd did a great job. And I mean, as we continue to be successful, we'd love to see more and more people come and get the shot rocking again.
Micah, in that stretch where they went on their run, just what's the conversation like in the huddle? Because I think, like Adam said, this is something that might have gone the other way last year. What's the conversation like in the team huddle when you call timeout and they're going on that run?
The biggest thing, Coach was very calm. I mean, he was just saying, like, the entire time, like, guys, this is exactly what we want. This is exactly what we want. This is fun. Like, this is competitive basketball, and this is what makes the game fun. And you know, he was just trying to keep our heads level, because it's very easy to get, you know, psyched out of your mind a little bit in those kind of intense situations. And Coach is very calm and did a really good job of keeping us all calm. And with that, we just continued to play our game, and we ended up making that run at the end of the game.
When did you find out that Caleb wasn't going to play, and was there any conversation with the coaches that you might need to play more minutes or play a certain way tonight that might be a little different?
Yeah, we found out a shoot around, you know, and with the minutes thing, I mean, like I said, it's whatever I got to do to help the team. It's next man up, and whether that may be playing, you know, all 40 minutes, or whether that may be, you know, not even playing at all and being a voice on the bench, I'm going to do whatever I can to help this team.
Musa, we've talked a lot about your journey to get here, and I was thinking about it today that you're making your first start, and I wonder if you weren't here and you were still a senior in high school, what would you be doing on a Thursday night?
Actually, I think they played tonight. I think my high school played tonight, maybe. But I'd probably be in the gym thinking about this moment right here. So, you know, I just work as hard as I can every day.
Is it a little surreal then to sit up here right now and think that that just happened?
Not really. You know, coming here, I always felt like this is what I was supposed to do. I never felt like I was, you know, skipping a chapter or something like that. Like, I'm not supposed to be here. I feel like this is exactly what I'm supposed to be doing.
Micah, when you first heard that Musa was going to be on this team and you knew he was going to be coming in as a high school senior, did you see this kind of performance and this kind of ability coming this early in his career?
I mean, he kind of proved it like the first day he was in the gym. I mean, he didn't really – when all the freshmen come in, it takes a little bit of time just to get acclimated to everything. And the one thing that he did was he offensive rebounded the crap out of the ball. Like, he got his hands on everything, and that opened everyone else's eyes. Like, it was unreal. Just getting his athleticism, he can get up there and get his hands on balls that honestly no one else can, is crazy. And then with that, just the way how hard he plays and how much good defense he plays, I think everyone knew that he was going to be ready to play.
Michael, you were pretty active those first couple minutes of the game, and their big guy got two fouls. He was fouling you twice. Did you go in thinking, like, trying to get him in foul trouble early that way to get him out of rhythm and things like that?
The game plan with him was just to be physical, and just bring the game to him. Don't let him bring the game to us. And obviously he's very big and very long. So being able to get those two fouls on him quick and have him get it out of the game helped us out a lot. Because obviously, you know, their pick and roll for a lob is dangerous. So being able to take him out of the game, I think we went on a run too. It was huge.
Hey, Musa, can you just talk about the importance of generating offensive boards and how that created momentum for the offense going forward?
I mean, just getting second opportunities. If we're not knocking down shots and the other team's getting the boards, they're going to push out and run and get easy layups. So, you know, it's just important to slow their offensive breakdown by getting the second opportunity.
Thanks, guys.